Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you? Hope you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEVS Home School. This is Wahid Noor, Assistant Teacher of Islamic Studies of National Ideal English Version School, Deshik. Today I am going to take the class of Islamic Studies for the students of class 8. Today our topic is Hajj from chapter 2, lesson 5 and 6. Dear students, before starting the Hajj, we have to know the definition of Hajj. I written there the definition. Hajj is an Arabic word which means to determine, to wish. In Islamic terminology, to perform some formalities in the Holy Kaaba and certain other places in appropriate ways on some particular days in order to earn the nearness of satisfaction of Allah, Almighty Allah, is called Hajj. Dear students, you can remember this definition by four steps. First of all, if you want to perform the Hajj, at first you have to make a niyot, which is called determination or wish. And then you have to perform the Hajj in a certain times, fixed times. And then you have to perform the Hajj in a certain places. I mean, you have to observe the certain places in the Saudi Arabia, I mean in Makkah and Medina. And last number, when you are performing the Hajj, your intention will be only the earning the nearness of Almighty Allah and making the happiness of Almighty Allah, nothing else. So then it will be counted as the Hajj. Now I will discuss upon whom Hajj is farz. Hajj is farz for those people who are able physical and economic after meeting all family expenditure and can bear the additional expenses up to the visit the Holy Kaaba and return home. Dear students, you can think upon whom Hajj will be farz. So there is also four items you have to remember. Number one is you have to be well physically. And then you have to be well economically, I mean enough money. And then you have to able to carry the family expenditure when you are being absent, I mean during the Hajj time. For example, 30 days or 40 days. And lastly, you have to be expense the extra money, I mean the rent of the plane or the rent of the hotel and returning from the Saudi Arabia, this type of money. And then upon you, Hajj will be farz. Well, now for female Hajjis, should be accompanied by her husband or that male persons with whom marriage is haram. For example, father, son, brother, uncle, maternal uncle, grandfather, etc. But all expenses should be borne by the female pilgrim. Dear students, for the female Hajjis, same condition what I written here, but another extra condition for the female Hajjis, they need a company. Without the company upon whom with the female pilgrims marriage is haram, they can make the company, and they are their brother or son or father or maternal uncle, etc. So with them, the female Hajjis can observe the Hajj, can perform the Hajj. Without that type of company, the female Hajjis cannot perform the Hajj. But another important information is, all expenses should be borne by the female pilgrims. The female Hajjis, she is making the company. So that company's expenses, the money, bear the female Hajjis. Well, now I will discuss the farz of Hajj. And you know there are three farz of Hajj, and this is very much important. If you leave, if you omit from here any of one, the Hajj will be cancelled. Number one is to put on ihram intending to perform Hajj. Then number two, to stay in the field of Arafat on the 9th Zilhajj and to conduct arrival of Tawaf Ziyarah. So first one is wearing the ihram, I mean white cloths without stitch. Number two is ukuf Arafat, staying in the field of Arafat in 9th Zilhaj, and last number, Tawaf e Ziyarat. For all Hajis, they have to Tawaf the Holy Kaaba. These three are important for us. And then I will discuss about the wajib of Hajj. To stay in the Muzdalifah on the way back from Arafat, when the pilgrims are coming back from the Arafat, they will stay in the Muzdalifah, that is one place name, and then to run in the middle of Safa and Marwa hills. This is called Sa'i. Dear students, Sa'i, to run from Safa hills to Marwa hills, but that run means not run, walking very fast, that's called Sa'i. Okay, then now number three, to throw stones at Shaitan. There will be a fixed place in the boundary, there will be a pillar, and when you will throw the stones, small stones, you will imagine in your mind that pillar is like a Shaitan, devil, and you are throwing to the Shaitan your stones. Okay, then now number four, Tawaf e Wida or departure Tawaf. Dear students, Tawaf e Wida is related those are coming the Makkah from outside from the Makkah. So those are coming into the Makkah from outside of Makkah. This is related, Tawaf e Wida for them. And number five, to have a head shape or haircut, you know about this. And then number six, to perform Qurbani. And last number, to perform Dam. Dear students, what is Dam? While performing the all wajibs of Hajj, if you break the consequence by performing the wajib of Hajj, then you have to perform the Dam. Dam is one kind of penalty. You have to sacrifice, you have to Qurbani animals, that is called Dam. Now I will discuss significance of Hajj. What is the importance of Hajj? I written there 6 points. Number one, Hajj is the fifth pillar of Islam. According to the Hadith, this is the fifth pillar. Number two, the world Muslims assemble in Mecca on the appointed days to gain the satisfaction of Allah. Number three, they perform all the formalities jointly with proper discipline. Number four, every pilgrim is covered with the same white dress, king or actor or player. Dear students, when the pilgrims are visiting the Holy Kaaba, when they are performing the Hajj, all the pilgrims wear the same dress, that is white dress, and they can be a king or they can be a president or prime minister or any actor or player, any kinds of person can be, but they will wear the same dress. And then number five, they involve in the single entity through the pronouncement of same words, although they are different in language, colors, and lifestyle. Dear students, those are performing the Hajj. All of them, our intention is, I am presenting to Almighty Allah, and my intention is, I am showing to Almighty Allah, I believe about the Almighty Allah, the entity of Almighty Allah, and all of the pilgrims, they are uttering the same words, that is, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, Labbaik La Sharika Laka Labbaik, Innal Hamda Wa Ni'mata Laka Wal Mulk La Sharika Lak. Every pilgrims are saying again and again that's words. Last number, Hajj unites the world Muslim with the bond of equity and fraternity. If you perform the Hajj, then the Muslim brotherhood will be more strong. So that was the significance, importance of Hajj. Now I will discuss about the fazilat of Hajj. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Man hajja lillah falam yarfuth walam yafsuq raja'a ka yawmi waladatuhu ummuhu. Dear students, Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam says there, I am telling the meaning, if you perform the Hajj, then if you don't do any indecent work during the Hajj, and if you not involve any bad deeds, and after returning from the Hajj, if you being the same, like a good person, then you will be like you came from your mother's right now, from your mother's womb. So how the baby being a innocent, then the pilgrims will be like that. Okay, now Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, another speech says, you keep performing Hajj and Umrah because those two ibadat are move poverty, wants and sin in the same way as the heat of fire purifies iron, gold and silver from dirt. The returns of Maqbul Hajj in the Hajj is only to Jannat Nasai. Dear student, Rasulullah ﷺ said, if you perform the Hajj or Umrah, then Almighty Allah will remove from you the poverty, the wants and any kinds of sins. Like when we are giving the heat of any iron or any gold or any silver, and then the dirt is removed from that materials, same as the pilgrims will be. And which we are doing the Mabrur Hajj, which is called the Maqbul Hajj, if you perform same as, then Allah will the feedback for the pilgrims, Jake Jannat. Well, now lastly, I will discuss some important information about the Hajj. Number one is, performing Hajj more than once will be regarded as nafal and enough reward. Dear students, if you want to perform the Hajj more than one times, for example, upon you Hajj is first and you perform that, and after that if you want to perform the Hajj, that will be counted as nafal. How many times you will perform, no problem at all, and you will get a lot of sawab. And then to establish the practice of salat, the first prayer house built in Makkah is called Baitullah, and Baitullah means the house of Allah. Our Prophet Almighty Allah ordered to the prophets for make order to the angels for making the build of Baitullah, and that is the first prayer house in the world. That's called Baitullah, and Baitullah means the house of Allah. And number three is, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, accompanied by his son Ismail, revealed the Holy Kaaba. Once a time, the Ismail alayhi salam and Ibrahim alayhi salam, father and son, revealed the Holy Kaaba. And then number four, by inheritance means the patrimony. The Quraysh family was in the charge of Kaaba and caretaker of Hajj. And last number, in Makkah, those who had disliked worshipping the statues, they were called Hanif or the devoted. Hanif means devoted. Dear students, at the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam or before the burning of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, there were the Hanif persons. Those who had disliked, those who had hated the worshipping of statues, idols, they were the Hanif person. They were idol person. They were good at that time. So I discuss all this only for you. I hope you understood. Keep practicing at home. Stay safe. Obey your parents. See you soon, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.